archaeoastronomers in Flagstaff, Arizona. The first one was simply a group of scholars of Mahabharata. There are 100 scholars whose specialty is Mahabharata. And I presented this talk there. And the reaction I got there was, the second conference in, it's actually the one in Bangalore, we had a number of scholars, but several of them were using the same type of software that I use. And they all came with different things. So we had a lot of heated discussion, and we parted this. The last one was a meeting with some archaeoastronomers. These are professional astronomers who study ancient astronomies all over the world. Of course, most of them had no background in Mahabharata, so I had to tell them what the Mahabharata story is and why I'm trying to date it and how I dated it. And they appreciated it. Well, these are some of the publications. I'll simply go through that. Well, we know that the epic Mahabharata is the greatest epic in the world. It's more than 3 times the size of the Iliad and the Odyssey combined, and it is has an important role in Indian culture. It's a living tradition, and of course, it the composition of the Mahabharata is actually it's called Jaya, one of the names of Mahabharata. Vyasa composed it, and at that time, it had only about 8,000 shlokas. Then he taught it to his son Shuka, who recited it to Vaishampayana. Vaishampayana recited this to Janamedaya at the time of Satyayaga, and by that time the epic grew to about 24,000 shlokas. Sutta, who heard this Mahabharata story at the Yaga, then went on and spread it around the world, and then the epic grew to 100,000 shlokas, and that is the present status. It has not changed in the last 1850 years. And in fact, when did the war itself occur? There is a shloka in the Adi Parva, the first book of Mahabharata. Antaretaiva samprapte kalit dvaparayorabhut chamanta panchate yuddham Kuru Pandava senayoho. The war between the Kuru and the Pandava army took place at the junction of Kali and Dwapara at Chamanta Panchaka. Chamanta Panchaka is another name for Kurukshetra. Well, for thousands of years we believe that. Nobody questions it. Follow traditions. For example, we celebrate Bhishmashtami. We celebrate Gita Jayanti. All based on this tradition. About 150 years ago, Western scholars began to take interest in our epics, and then the story started. The first thing they said was, it's all a myth. It's a figment of imagination. In Mahabharata, what we can't take place at all. And some of them said, no, it was probably a small family feud, a tribal fight, which was exaggerated by the poetic imagery, and it has been blown into a huge epic. So if it was, even if it was a small fight, then it must have been a historic event, so it must have taken place. And so, then began the problem of finding the date of that Mahabharata war. It became an industry. There are more than 200 papers that have been published on finding the date of the Mahabharata war alone. Nothing to do with what Mahabharata teaches us and so on, what we learn from that, but just finding when it happened, if it happened. And you see, this is a graph of the number of authors promoting the dates. So there are dates going from 5000 BC all the way to 600 AD. And you see a large number promote the date around 3000. These are mostly Indian scholars who follow the tradition that it is around Kali Yuga. That's how many 250 years is for this graph purposes. And Kali Yuga started, as we know, around 3100 BC, and so that gives us the date. most Western scholars prefer the data around 1,000 or even 1,500. And they use a variety of techniques, linguistics, textual evidence from Vedic texts, genealogical texts, Vamshavali from Puranas, astronomical references, and archaeological evidence. And more than 40% of all the papers are based on astronomical evidence. And so if you just look at those 40 papers, or 40% of the papers, and see what kind of dates they come up with, astronomical evidence, and we find the same distribution. In fact, a majority around 3,000, and then all the way going from 5,000 BC to 600 AD. And these are some of the recent works. In fact, when I first started, there were two works that had just appeared in print. One was by Professor Kochhar, who was the director of ISRO in Bangalore, the Indian Space Research Organization. And he published a book called The Vedic People, and he gave a date of 955 BC. Professor Siddharth, who is the director general of the Bangla Planetarium in Hyderabad, he published a book, The Celestial Sky to the Vedas, and he gave a date of 1311 BC. Here we have two astrophysicists giving two different dates. And then there is one by Professor Raghavan, who is a mathematician from Chennai, and he gave a date of 1367 BC. And Professor Sen Gupta, also a mathematician and an eminent Sanskrit scholar, gave a date of 2449 BC. So here I have a sample of dates, which are all done by astronomers and astrophysicists. And I have a software, so I can test this. So I want to look for what are the types of astronomical references that are indicated. Eclipses and planetary positions such as Saturn, Mars, and so on, tithis and nakshatras, equinoxes and solstices, and there's a whole lot of these. So where do these occur? They occur all over the place. There are 18 parvas in Mahabharata, and you find astronomical references in practically all of them. There are two parvas which contain the largest number of astronomical references. That is, one is book number 5, which is Udyoga Parva, and book number 6, which is Bhishma Parva. In Udyoga Parva, the most important event is Krishna goes on a diplomatic mission of peace. The Pandavas, after the Ajnatavasa, are staying in a place called Upaplavya Nagara, and so Krishna leaves Upaplavya Nagara and goes to Hastinapura. Vyasa describes in detail the tithi, the nakshatra, and the muhurta when Krishna left. Vyasa must have given great importance to this peace mission, because of that event he gives all kinds of information, but he doesn't give much information about the war itself. War itself probably was not that important for him. And that's why the problem is. And the Bhishma Parva, which contains a large number of data, I'll talk about that a little later. On the eve of the war, Vyasa meets with Dhritarashtra and describes to him the omens that he has seen